Hey guys, Space Guru 5 here. Before I get started with today's dissection, I'd like to go over a few key things. Let me introduce you to the walfas community. I'm pretty sure that's how you pronounce it. This is a community going back to 2007 that was inspired by characters from a Japanese shooter game series called Toho Project. The Toho Project series has spawned a wide array of fan communities, and it has been adapted into anime, manga, music, novelizations, and so on. The walfas site itself is used to create custom characters in this particular style, which reminds me of sites like SP Studio. One could also use the site to create comic strips, animations, and really anything you want to. Due to the site's flexibility, it has spawned a wide array of communities and has even partially spread to the CC. For the purposes of this video, we'll only be talking about a community called walfas-ssr. Walfas-ssr is a community on DeviantArt that was founded by RED-IMPRISONER, the subject of today's dissection, on the 6th of November, 2017. Despite its membership of 2 admins and 23 regular users, only 5 users seem to be active on it, including RED-IMPRISONER himself. The group itself evidently takes heavy inspiration from the USSR, right down to the name, and it is full of walfas characters and settings reminiscent of Soviet propaganda, and also full of guns. Now, one might look at this and assume this is just roleplay. I know I certainly did at first glance. However, what I'm about to show you should make you think otherwise. That said, let's start dissecting RED-IMPRISONER. RED-IMPRISONER is a 21-year-old Russian man named Alexander. Much like the WSSR group he founded, he himself is particularly infatuated with Soviet propaganda and guns, all with walfas characters used profusely. He also espouses opinions that many people would consider controversial. For example, he is strongly opposed to the LGBT. Let's take a look at this submission called Hard to Argue with This. This is simply an image macro talking about transgenders and how they'd like to be addressed, with a Doctor Who meme used as the reaction. The description is the best part. Allow me to read this verbatim. "And because the rainbowish brats shall be placed into asylums and prisons, not walking in so-called parades, and demonstrating their close-to-fascist dogmas." In other words, by simply having a sexuality that isn't a heterosexual norm, or by being transgender, you deserve to be imprisoned or put in mental institutions, you don't deserve to celebrate who you are, despite literally centuries of oppression, and your dogmas are reminiscent of fascism. Yeah, this guy has no idea what the fuck he's even talking about. First of all, nobody chooses their sexuality. They find out about it when they hit puberty and reach sexual maturity. Someone being homosexual, bisexual, or transgender has literally no effect on you as a person. Not even a little bit. It has just as much of an effect on you as your sexuality has on them. Let's also go over your mental institution argument. Studies have shown that people of different sexualities are indeed mentally there, so there's literally no reason for all of them to be sent to asylums. You only want them there because you don't like them and you want them extricated from society. And the imprisonment thing? The only countries imprisoning the LGBT just for existing are those with strict theocracies. Even ignoring that, how is it a crime for gay people just to exist? They're not inherently doing anything wrong, they're just attracted to people of the same sex instead of the opposite sex. How does that constitute a criminal offense, considering that them just existing literally does nothing to you? Yet again, this is an example of you wanting a group of people extricated from society for no other reason other than you just don't like them. Second of all, wow, you're basically saying that the LGBT has no right to celebrate who they are. Did your history classes not go over the centuries of LGBT oppression? In the Middle Ages, gays were considered heathens due to the verse of Leviticus talking about how gays should be killed. Such practices continued into the early modern age, with gays still being burned at the stake for their impurity. LGBT people were mass executed during the Holocaust and World War II, being identified with downward-pointing pink triangles. Even now, while sex between consenting adults, regardless of their sexuality, is legal in much of the Western world, the LGBT still faces a lot of discrimination in these places. Let's even talk about Russia. Even though in Russia, the LGBT has some freedoms, there are no laws prohibiting discrimination of homosexuals, bisexuals, or transgender people. Households headed by same-sex couples have way fewer benefits than those headed by different-sex couples. Homosexuality was only recently declassified as a mental illness there, like not even 20 years ago. It also doesn't help that the majority of Russians don't accept the LGBT in any single way. And yet you're gonna sit here and claim that they have no right to celebrate who they are? You are literally part of the problem. Third of all, do you even know what fascism is? Fascism is a political ideology that emphasizes ultranationalism and operates within a totalitarian framework. Governments that have adhered to fascism are led by a dictator and run solely by the military. This is the type of ideology where violence against undesired groups of people is encouraged and even committed by the state. How is this in any way what the LGBT and its advocates want? The only thing most of them want is to have the same rights as heterosexual counterparts. That's it. They're not some faux Soviet Union trying to brainwash people into believing that communism is the only thing that's right, and that enemies of the state should be extricated from society altogether. Oh wait. Now that we've got his anti-LGBT rhetoric out of the way, let's move on to his general behavior online, because that's where the real fun stuff begins. If you want an example of someone with a volatile personality, RED-IMPRISONER sure fits that example well. He makes comics where his characters threaten people he doesn't like with violence, he gets into arguments with people who call him out on his behavior and his bullshit, he has the nerve to consider non-heterosexualities perversion, lump them in the same group as fetishists and pedophiles, and even ban them from his group. Not like any of them would want to join anyway. He actually posts what look like official WSSR documents on his profile and on the group itself, like he's actually a fucking governor or something. And he glorifies the USSR while failing to understand its totalitarian elements, using it as just an excuse to talk shit about the Western world. Let's go over these one at a time, shall we? Before he founded WSSR, RED-IMPRISONER was a member of another group known as Walfas Station Wagon, which seems to be intended for Walfas and Toho fans in general. After an apparent falling out with the group and its admins that resulted in his ban, RED-IMPRISONER took it upon himself to create a comment where the founder's spastic character is implied to be murdered. I'll go into the full details a bit later on, but regardless of what happened, nothing could ever excuse such blatant violence against someone solely because they don't like them. He also made a comic in which a person in a Soviet cyber suit terrorizes characters found in WSW. He justifies this one by claiming this. I think it's because they, as in my fatherland we would say, dunked on. They understood that kill yourself is easier than dissuade me. I told them I never change my minds. I told them I'm ready for dialogues. I told them that there are things that are offensive not for them, maybe, but for me. But they prefer to shut up and melt after insulting me in different ways. Same stuff with the WC. I'm not surprised. Let's talk about why he got banned in the first place. In WSW, he posted journal entries and comics, which have apparently been removed from the group, in which he glamorized Soviet imagery and expressed his hatred of the LGBT, going so far as to call them diseased criminals and assholes. Whenever people called him out on it for expressed concern about this rhetoric, he just shot them down with his own stubborn ideas. Heck, even in that comment, he said he'll never change his mind. And this is quite clear because even now he still has these thoughts and ideas. What really drove things overboard is when he decided to attack one of WSW's members for being a lesbian and for not accepting his works into her own group. The most hilarious part is when he actually tried bargaining with one of the WSW admins when he was faced with being banned. Well, I can delete the comics, hide comments, but I won't change my opinion even after that. I'll hide delete all provocative materials, but all of us won't make any materials about homophilia, homophobia, and any allusions to it. I know that even here it's such a harsh theme, and we have all just understood it. Thankfully, the admins had the common sense to extricate him permanently despite these efforts, and the members of WSW reached the consensus that he was no longer welcome in the group. So yeah, he doesn't think that attacking someone over their sexuality is a big deal. If anything, he encourages it and takes part in it itself. Yeah, no wonder he was fucking ousted. Let's also go over his glorification of the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics, the great totalitarian regime he loves so much. On the 16th of August 2018, he made a journal entry in which he presents his distorted view of what the USSR was, never mind that he was born 6 years after the USSR fell apart. Let's read a few excerpts, shall we? I know that for most DA participants, the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics is kinda like terra incognita, which is populated by angry bears, evil KGB agents, insidious mafia, who developing balalaikas, matryoshkas, vodka, etc. I officially tell you, this is nothing but primitive propaganda of Western and not only liberastic mass media. The Soviet Union was like when you walk through the streets of your home city at any time of the day and nobody will even attack, will not say any rude word. A grill on the windows of the first floor, are you crazy, is apartment a prison? iron locking doors in the porches. What a wildness! Not only entrances, but also cellars with attics were opened, and there were no hobos or druggies in them, because they weren't at all. The Soviet Union had the best education in the world, for free. That is, in no country in the world, such education, even for millions, you would not get, in citizens of the USSR, for free, and then, a guarantee of your work on your specialty. The Soviet Union was like when on the TV and are not slaughters, not scams, send an SMS to a short number, not silicone prostitutes and not kettle humor, but good films and enlightening programs. This is basically his way of saying, things were so much better when the Soviet Union was still a thing. Why can't we live in a world where Mother Russia is free of influence from the filthy capitalist Western world? Well, I'll tell you why. Because things weren't better when the Soviet Union was still a thing. Very recently, someone posted a long comment essentially exposing his journal as being bullshit. I left a link to it in the description in case you want to read it, but I'll go ahead and read a few bits from it. Nice tall tales. Too bad the author forgot to mention sanatoriums, apartments for young families, and many other allegedly free services require waiting in line, same with basic goods like furniture and vehicles. The deficit was prevalent in not only production, as it is well known, but in service industry and housing, with union failing to deliver sufficient housing before its belated collapse. Apartments also weren't just given away. They belonged to factory or other enterprise one of the family members worked for, and could thus be claimed from family any time, evicting them in favor of a new employee's one. Some claims you make are so patently false, I wouldn't be surprised if your nose stretched so hard it hit your own back. Soviet television was absolutely underdeveloped, full program barely reaching 8 hours a day of content. Broadcasting news and events without any proper development of shows, formats like documentaries were entirely unheard of. Same with economy. It's actually easy to verify that there were multiple registered cases of sudden price hikes, including in basic amenities. That's why people didn't bother leaving in banks, actually. A sudden deflation of currency would leave banks paralyzed and you unable to expend currency quickly enough. With Soviet economy literally stagnating for decades, unable to raise GDP since the late 60s, it's no wonder it was a mess, really. Let's also not forget the Chernobyl disaster of 1986, which was caused by the number of design flaws overlooked and even lied about within the regime, and leaked an unprecedented amount of ionizing radiation into the atmosphere. Oh, and let's also not forget the Iron Curtain, which led to the creation of the Berlin Wall. Now, in case you don't know, the Berlin Wall blocked off the Soviet-controlled East Germany from the rest of Western Europe from 1961 to 1989, when calls for democratic reform were becoming more widespread and the unification of Germany was imminent. If the USSR was really as free as you claimed it to be, then these actions would have been unnecessary and the Berlin Wall wouldn't have become a global symbol of communist repression. If you want more examples of totalitarian regimes restricting freedoms, just look at North Korea, which was also influenced by the USSR. However, instead of facing the facts about his beloved USSR, he decries all of it as Western propaganda. Observe the reply he sent to the aforementioned dissenter. You're saying this only because A, you're trusting everything that is from West, and B, you haven't got any bonuses from your current status. I personally don't know how you call the situation went from being one of the richest Soviet republic from USSR during the 25 years of independence, drive down to the fact that the only thing you may give is only Sovietophobia, Russophobia. Last I checked, these are actual things that happened. We're not making this up, this isn't propaganda. Real people were affected by this shit throughout the entire time that the USSR was in existence. It's this overt denial that really calls your mental state into question. What this looks like is someone with purely grandiose delusions about the USSR. I mean, let's just look at these fucking documents he posted. Shit like this is just way too much. You're not a governor, you're not a bureaucrat, you're not someone with any real power. You're just another nobody who owns a group of other collective nobodies, taken from someone who owns his own group and is a moderator of two others. So that's RED-IMPRISONER for you. He's a delusional faux communist who hates the LGBT, glamorizes the USSR as being the most perfect nation to ever exist, obsesses over Soviet imagery, has a perpetual hate boner for the Western world, and tries to act like an old battle-worn Soviet war veteran, even though he's only barely a month older than me. Can there be any dumber fucking thing? Say what you want about Crystal Dark Girls 101, but at least she didn't espouse genuine hatred of an entire group of people just for existing. Say what you want about Kayforia, but at least he only ever gets mad at his critics and detractors. This guy tries so hard to be like his definite idol Joseph Stalin. In reality, he's more like a faux Vasily Stalin. He's just someone trying to use his supposed connection to the Soviet regime to try and boost his own social status. Never mind that in the end, Vasily's life turned for the worse after his father died. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, Sasha, but this is why no one will ever take you seriously. You need to get a reality check and stop harassing people. Maybe then people will actually want to accept you into the many groups you've continuously begged to be a part of. That's about it for today, folks. I'm SpaceGuru5, and as always, take care. Oh, and, Alex, if you're gonna get mad at me over this, because I know you will, I'm just reminding you, you're letting a guy on YouTube that uses Wile E. Coyote as his avatar get to you. I'm just letting you know, alright? You let fucking me get to you. Suka.